Yeah, I think Ryan, next time I'm joining you. I'm running against you and I'm ready for it. But before we do that, let's make a delicious and nutritious meal that we'll need after all of that running.
Clover cheese is for those who love life, where everything falls into place and melts away our cares, adding joy and stretching our imagination. Clover, for the love of cheese.
Made with love by Clover.
Now, before you go running, if a no-fuss, one-pan, cupboard staple breakfast recipe is what you're after, then a Strata is the answer. It's ultimate homemade convenience food. Essentially, it's a breakfast casserole, which you can add anything to. And I love the idea of that. We've opted for a mouth-watering clover feta and pilchard breakfast Strata, which you are absolutely going to love. And here to help us make it and bring it to life is one of my favorites, Teresa Alliate.
Hello.
Teresa, good morning.
How
good
are you?
Morning. I'm so, so good.
Good.
You and I were just chatting about running just
yes,
now.
Yes.
You went running yesterday.
I did.
5Ks.
Yes.
And now you've got a meal as a post sort of running type of nutritious experience that you want to
yes,
offer us.
Yes, fantastic breakfast. Very nutritious, very colourful, and it's going to keep you full until lunchtime. Maybe
I love
beyond.
That. I love that.
So I'm going to start cooking our veggies, and I'm going to ask you to do some whisking for me, please.
Okay, cool. So would you like me to start over here with what we've got here?
Yes, please.
Okay, so we've got some eggs going
into our yogurt.
Our yogurt.
Yeah.
So
pantry staples, again, very, very easy to put together.
Eggs into yogurt, some of our clover fresh milk going into that mix.
Perfect.
A pinch of pepper and salt.
Yes.
Or, in the right order, salt and pepper.
Perfect.
And then you want me just whisking all of this together.
That's great. So what I've done is I've heated up...
Stop laughing, Graham. And while you're...
I'm softening some red onion here, and I'm going to add some courgettes, which we've cubed.
Nice.
So... also, the other thing is, if you have any leftover vegetables in the fridge, you can use them in a dish like this, leftover veggies or meat, and you can make a whole nother meal out of them.
Oh, that is so great, because
really
there often
handy.
Is a lot of leftover vegetables when you've cut a bit too much more than what you need for whatever dish you're making.
There's always that one leek or, you know, the three mushrooms that are kind of sitting there all lonely, so pop them in this dish, and you're all sorted.
Nice.
So you're going to soften all your veggies.
Okay.
I'm going to add some herbs. These are just dried herbs.
Those are cucumbers, eh?
This is courgette.
Oh, courgette.
Yeah.
But if you were making courgettes, for example, because they're obviously quite watery, is high heat the right way to make sure that they're not going too watery in the pan there?
Yeah, a medium is usually fine. If you're worried about that, you can turn the heat up.
Okay,
you don't want to burn your onions. So
you want to manage the heat factor there. Okay,
yes, so I'm going to pop in some pilchards as well in tomato sauce. So we've got some extra protein there, and just mix that all together, nice and easy. And this is a breakfast, but if you wanted to do this step the night before to save time in the morning, you could absolutely do that.
And let's be honest, the mornings are all about that rushing around. Sometimes you do want to make sure that you're prepped the night before. It saves you all the trouble.
Exactly.
But I love that this is such a versatile breakfast. It can be done for everyday breakfasting.
Yes,
or you can do it for the weekend when you are hosting a brunch or a breakfast at your house. So when your guests are coming through, this is something really experiential to have them enjoy.
It is.
Great. Right. Okay, I'm done here.
That looks perfect. Well done.
Thank you very much. A gold star for the day.
Yes, yes. Okay, so if you have an oven-proof pan, you can put this straight in the oven.
Fantastic.
Or what you're going to do is you're going to put it into your oven-proof dish. So just, making a bit of a mess.
If it's not messy, then are you even doing anything right? That's what I say. That's my philosophy.
I like that.
Is it? And it's actually a fact, right?
I'm going to use that,
from now on.
So look at that colour. It just looks beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And then what we're going to do is top it with some bread cubes. Mm. So if you have any bread that's about to go stale, that's perfect for this dish.
That's great.
So we've got some ciabatta, but you could use any bread that you have, even if it's sandwich bread. It's perfect.
And then
clover feta
it's
goes
about
on
to
top.
Rich.
Oh, feta makes everything better.
It does. Well, you know that you can try this recipe using clover, white cheddar, Gouda, or even feta. Anything goes. Whatever you've got at your house, whatever you do like. It's nothing but elite quality and that elite taste, elite texture with clover cheese that will ensure that you get the very best results. And when I say the very best results, that's an offer and not a challenge. And you're going to love this one. It's so rich and so creamy. I love it.
So you're going to pop it in the oven for 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. You want that bread to be golden and crispy.
Mm-hmm.
And then top it with some extra feta before you serve it.
You can never have enough cheese. But listen, if you want to get this recipe, we've made it pretty simple for you. We've loaded it onto our website, expressoshow.com. You will find all of the ingredients you're going to need there as well. The taste, or the proof, rather, is in the tasting.
Yes.
As I like to say. Teresa, this looks so, so good. Really, it's an indulgent breakfast.
Mm, it looks fantastic. You've got your protein, you've got your veggies.
All the goodness that you're looking
really
for.
That's really good.
And of course, the cheese. You'll get nowhere without the cheese.
Don't forget
the cheese. Okay, I'll tell you.
Dig in.
Scrumptious.
You ready for that run now?
Not yet. I'm going to eat a lot more of this, and then I might consider running.
Fair enough.
One more time. If you forgot that website, it's expressoshow.com. The recipe is there. All the ingredients are there. But if you missed any of the steps involved and what all that magic that Teresa's brought to the kitchen this morning, we've prepared this for you. Watch it.
Made with love by Clover.